Christmas time is here, and it looks like Bishop Earl Boyea exchanged a gift with the Holy Father, Pope Francis, and he's nice enough to call from Vatican City inside Rome there on our AT&T line right now. Buongiorno, buon Natale, Your Grace.
Hey, buongiorno, Mike. How are you doing?
I'm so pleased to hear from you. I know you're very busy and that you were with the Holy Father, and would you mind telling us what that is like and what you talked about, and we'll be
sure.
Quiet and listen just like it's a homily.
Okay, Michael, you know, before I get into that, I just want you to know I'm at the top of the North American College here, and on my right is the sun beating down on me. It's about 55 degrees. I'm in my shirt sleeves, and to my left I can see St. Peter's, and straight ahead of me I can see the city of Rome clear as a bell and the Apennine Mountains, and there's snow in the distance on the mountains. I guess you're having a little different weather.
Well, the food's not as good back here in Lansing, but you're doing okay.
That's right.
I have stood on that roof where you're standing in the past with now Bishop Jerry Vinke, and you're right. Yeah. It's one of the most beautiful spots in the Eternal City.
Right. Well, we had a wonderful visit with the Holy Father. You know, the kind of general sense I had is he is very, very personally very orthodox. He really believes strongly in the ongoing teaching of the Church. I know a lot of people get confused by him and claim to be confused by him because he allows others to be doing and saying things. And we're not quite sure how to deal with all that all the time. But certainly, I mean, he's really a solid man. He's very kind to us. Listen, we talked for about 2 hours and had wonderful conversations. We could ask anything we wanted, and he tried to answer as best he could. He spoke in Italian, had an interpreter right next to him translating him in English. I understood most of what he said in Italian. I can't speak it very well anymore, but I can understand it quite well. But so what? It was a wonderful, wonderful day. It really was.
Did you have a specific question for the Holy Father?
Well, my staff wanted me to ask him there in the Curia back in Lansing. They wanted me to ask him if it'd be possible to restore the octave of Pentecost, kind of to emphasize the role of the Holy Spirit, the power of the Holy Spirit in our lives. And so I asked that, and he said, oh, that's interesting. He said, write me a letter.
He said, let's talk. In the posting from the Diocese of Lansing on Facebook and other social media, you're seeing there's a gift between the two of you in a beautiful photo there. First of all, what room is that in which you're in, and is the gift coming from the Pope to you or you to the Holy Father, and what is it?
We always present a check to the Holy Father for his activities, his charitable activities, and so that's what that usually is, and we all give him that. He gave to each one of us a medallion with his coat of arms on the back, and then some holy cards, and then a handful of rosaries is really what they were for us, and so we generally give those to other people. What I've been doing, frankly, I still have some from Pope Benedict, and I think I might even have one left from John Paul. But when I go and pray before abortion clinics or something like that, and there's little kids there praying as well, I usually give one of them the rosary that I've used. So, and they're always thrilled to have one from the Holy Father. So I'll be able to give out some more rosaries.
Oh, that's beautiful. And just as an aside, I saw yesterday the Pope may, in sorts, win a Golden Globe Award and maybe an Academy Award because there's a film coming out called The Two Popes with Anthony Hopkins, and that film was nominated for Best Picture, and the man playing Pope Francis is nominated for Best Actor. So, you know, isn't that something? At least we have a popular film now in the culture that will examine the relationship between these two. And I don't imagine you ran into Pope Benedict while you were there, or did you?
No, we did not. Our schedule is so incredibly packed. It's amazing. We're constantly being moved around by bus from one place to the next. So it's not easy to do. Tomorrow I have Mass. We have Mass. Our group has Mass over at St. Mary Major, where the Pope always goes before and after each international visit that he makes. And, in fact, I'll be preaching there to the group. So,
wow.
Fascinating about that.
What will your message be?
Basically just about the role of Mary and as kind of the messenger of the Lord. And so just talk a little bit. Very brief. I've been told, be brief.
Well, that is the old adage to advice for speakers. Be brief, brother, and in yours in case it can be brief, Bishop. But I don't know anybody in town that wouldn't love to pull up a chair and hear all of the details about what it's like to be in the presence of the Holy Father in such a glorious and historic setting.
Yeah, he was so relaxed.
Yeah.
He was really very much at ease, and so were all of us. In fact, we have a rather small group of Michigan, Ohio. There were only 17 of us, and I know last week he had a group of over 40. So it was kind of nice, the smaller group. He even said, this is a more humane gathering. so he likes that.
If you see Bishop Reisha, would you get him a cappuccino on me if the two of you are there together? I would appreciate that very much.
We're with each other all the time, so I will do that.
As you know, our listeners in northern Michigan, in Traverse City and through Gaylord and all that way, are getting to know him after his first year or two in that position there, so we like to keep them in the loop, too. I know that you're on your way now to these various appointments throughout Vatican City and Rome, and would you mind, though, giving
Michael Patrick,
a...
Yep. Michael Patrick, this particular time, I'm getting ready for lunch.
Oh, gosh. And where will that be?
Right here at the college.
Oh, okay. And so the lunch that I had there was up on the roof, if you can believe that, when Father Vinky brought a bowl of pasta and a bottle of Chianti, and we sat up there and ate noodles and drank wine. It was pretty cool.
Yeah, it's not that warm now.
Oh, okay. Well, would you warm our hearts with a Christmas blessing at this stage, if you don't mind?
Sure. Heavenly Father, send your many blessings upon all of the listeners to this radio station. Please, Heavenly Father, fill them with your love and your peace, especially families who feel grief or at this time feel pain or division of any kind. Grant healing, grant peace, grant unity, and grant patience, Heavenly Father. Pour your spirit upon all of us, and we pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.
We promise to pray for you, and we hope you'll do the same for us. And God bless you and the Holy Father and everybody there at Vatican City. And thank you. Grazie mille, Paisan Padre, for the call.
Thank you, Patrick. God bless you.
Ciao, Bella.